as we go along. Right, buttons. Switch the screen. All right. So as you saw earlier, this is the new Velvet stage. I've
Ah, yep, I see
received,
that.
yeah, I've done a couple changes to two or so of the characters, and a couple visual, I guess visual cues for people who are watching the match. So before, when you knocked a person down, the only way to really know whether or not they could quick rise from it was if they quick rise. Now, if you see, they actually flash a red color if it's a hard knockdown. We already had a bit of a flashing color for if they could tech in air, but giving more of those kind of color-coded cues, I'm sprinkling them into the match. It will make it easier to understand what's going on in the fight. Same thing happens if you hit them against the wall. They can't tech off the wall. It just goes. Yeah, we still haven't changed the Ollie idol. That was packed away into the polished stage. We're getting there though. We are headed straight into that part of development. It'll be nice and pretty, and you'll figure out something to do with this idol pose soon enough. I will miss it too. Yeah, she's happy. She's too happy. That's the only problem. She is working with really, really dark magics here. Pretty serious
Yes.
character. I can hear you.
Okay, cool.
What was the issue?
I went into Hangouts and then everything died.
All right.
That's the issue.
Fair enough. But yeah, for the most part, Aleander plays around the same. Not much changed on her end. But literally leading up to, 5 minutes before the stream, I was able to finish the rest of Paprika's base attacks and or her like her magic system. I think she only needs one more magic ability that I may or may not add soon, and her level 2 super. I have no idea how I managed to finish in time, but now that I've said that, it's going to break on stream. But that's half the fun. Way her magic system works, like everyone has their own kind of special system, with the little bar above the number there. Actually set this to limited. So you hit your magic button, you hand your opponent a gift. You can throw this forward. You can throw it upwards. The different kinds of gifts give you different kinds of buffs when you eat them. Let me go into normal. Actually, normal's this way. Hey, where is normal? Why didn't it go? There we go. So if you eat the apple as either character, you gain health. If you eat the dragon fruit, I'm probably going to change that to something a bit more appealing. You gain super meter. It gives you a whole lot of this stuff. But the issue is, if you accept any of the gifts that Paprika gives you, it actually regenerates her ammo, so she can throw more towards you because you are enjoying these gifts. If she eats them, she just enjoys it alone. It doesn't give her another shot. As you saw earlier, She was also throwing a flower pot. Right now, the gifts are random. There are going to be actual inputs you do to send the different kinds of gifts individually for an extra cost. But if you throw the flower pot, it actually hits them once, it bounces into there, and then hits again for an overhead attack, which means you have to block it while standing. A lot of these things come together to create a really scary set of situations where you have a gift looming above your head, sometimes twice, while she's actively trying to attack you from above or below. Or even behind, because she can run around the screen. Another type of gift she can throw out, I didn't make a graphic for this because I didn't have time, is she can very slightly kiss and roll a tiny little object across the screen, very slowly. This hits low and causes you to trip. Once again, you have objects coming from all sides, highs, lows, all kinds of stuff. And some of them are covering the ground and could give you buffs if you pick them up. What this character wants to do is just overload you with information and, you know, tantalizing objects. The way the pickups work is if you stand over it, it locks out a certain button. So like for certain attacks or certain items, it would be like you can't jab if you're standing over it. Instead, you'll eat. Another, you could stand over it, you can't hit medium attacks, etc. But of course, that craziness is limited because of the magic meter. It'd be crazy otherwise. You could just do this all day and have an infinite amount of health buffs, which would make her impossible to beat. But because she only has 6, it kind of levels out, and both players can mess around with that. Now, her super, it just teleports off the screen, hits you from whatever side she chooses. You can choose to go from where you started or go from the other side. And just like all other level 1s, you can cancel it into a level 2. If you have enough meter, of course. Which I don't, because I am dumb. So if you have at least 2 meters, yeah, it's pretty crazy. If you cancel it, she pulls out a picnic basket. That is really hard to see. Alright. This picnic basket, if you're standing near it, will give you 6 free gifts. Or it will disappear after its timer runs out. Its timer is actually pretty low right now. I need to change that. But that's basically her method of maintaining this crazy kind of playstyle. Again, this was finished like 5 minutes before the stream. It's completely untested. It's probably the most broken stuff on the planet, but I really want to try this at least once. She just drops the picnic basket. Now she has free gifts from this location. Of all kinds. That's 6 free gifts. It disappears. She continues. Now there's a bunch of stuff on the stage. And remember, if you eat it, she gets it. Or she's supposed to get it. So this gives her a way to reload her magic if she's running low. This character is... she's pretty crazy at the moment. The stuff like this kinda makes her scary, but I'm really interested in seeing how this plays out when we get this into testing. Should be fun. Yeah, kill them with kindness, that's exactly it. These are just gifts. They just happen to be heavy and hit you in the face. Yeah, I try to keep the characters like combat within the character. Like that's half the fun of this project is that we're essentially just creating a cartoon that you play. You're playing as these crazy characters, and they're always staying in character when they're fighting. Ah, GOAT. I can't wait to get to GOAT. That's gonna be fun. I have a trillion ideas for that character, but we'll get to that post-release. I just need to stay focused. So many ideas. But yeah, that's Paprika at the moment. Most of her magic system's finished up. She might get one more magic that'll let her that would give her another teleport, but she might already be really good, just as is.
I'm really excited to play this her, if I can figure her out.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. Not quite as crazy as Palm. It would be a bit easier to pick her up. I mean, you're just throwing gifts and running around the screen.
That's
A
true.
lot more approachable. But yeah, there's definitely some nasty stuff you can do with this character once you get a hang of how everything works. Any ideas after GOAT? We still technically have the at least set of moves we were going to use for the rest of the characters in the previous project. So there's definitely a whole pool of ideas for new characters after that. I mean, I'm still making a game as a fan of grapplers without an official grappler. So there's still at least that to look forward to if we make it that far. Like, I have an obligation to make a grappler. I mean, Paprika kinda can be played as one if you really wanna get it that way because of the whole kiss grab thing. You can do some weird setups with that. But yeah, as Paprika. Other character that received a couple changes. Not quite as drastic, I guess. Oh, actually, yeah, this is pretty drastic. I forgot we. I think I only showed this on the forums. Speaking of really difficult characters to play, I don't remember if this was this shown on last stream. Doesn't matter. I'll show it again. Because of the whole visual cue thing, I applied different colors to the puppies themselves when they're being used. So if you see there, they flash white when I'm calling them to command to move them. It'll flash like that. If I
Oh yeah, I
use
noticed that earlier.
an attack with them, they flash red. So you know something's coming. Especially useful if you're going up against the Big Mama. Now you know she's getting ready to do something. She tends to take kind of a slight pose. You don't really have a good way of timing it. At least in its current form because of lack of animation.
Player feedback.
Yeah. That's a visual feedback that's really important for both players and viewers. Yeah. Flashes red, flashes white. Another thing that is going to help a lot for players trying to actually get used to playing this character is, yeah, you're commanding this army all the time, but what if you just have a specific spot you want them to go to? Well, now you can double tap magic and they'll flip towards you, no matter where they are on the screen. So you can get them in position for whatever combo setups you're going for. No matter what. They're on separate sides of you, but you want to combo them from here. Double tap, do that. Me just continue all your stuff. Of course, also works with Big Mama. If you want to see a giant dog flip through the sky, it's really horrifying. There's no escape. Yeah, the puppetry has been increased. Chaotix Dog Team, that is excellent. I always did want to play that game. I've only seen it being played. I think that's about it for her. She does not yet have her level 2. I'm working on it. If you repeat your level 1, another dad doesn't come out anymore until the first one leaves the screen. That was creating problems. Besides that, that's Palm. A bit easier to use, a bit easier to see what is happening on the screen. Very important. Let's see, turn off the tech. Red, and then it turns blue when they can tech. Right, next character that got some changes. Tian got a couple changes for her level 2. A lot of it's still work in progress, lots of ideas being tested at once. Easy mode would be to just make her level 2, you know, give you infinite magic or something like that. But I want to try all the stuff around that, you know. I want to see what more unique ideas can go into that, or I guess more fun visual ideas can go into that. So before her level 2, when you did it, all that it did was it will change the way that your air attacks did worked. Like, it would turn everything into a kind of a double hit attack, and it was a little confusing to kind of switch modes like that because it completely changed the base level combos you could do. So rather than changing the normals, I'm actually looking into changing the specials instead and maybe some other underlying changes. So her regular special moves are the uppercut that causes a spike on the second hit, that shove that kind of lifts him up in the air and then hits him against the wall, and another move that was actually recently changed, if you guys remember that kind of pillar attack where she dragged you to the ground, that's now an Azuna drop, because Azuna drops are just awesome. Oh crap, I managed to kill her. I thought I turned that off. That definitely crashed the game, hold on. I forgot to reset the health. Man, almost made it through the stream without crashing the game. Oh well. Alright, all this stuff set back. That's good. Yeah, people quite enjoy the crouch. Stuff like the crouch, like that's the kind of direction we're going for with all of Tian's animations. Kind of emphasize her snake-like appearance by giving her a bunch of like slithery movements and, you know, kind of just curved poses and all that stuff. Be fun. Once we actually get the rest of the model working up. But yeah, as I was trying to show, this is now an Azuna drop. Previously, the move would do damage based on the height you hit from, because it hit a trillion times on the way down. Over time, this got optimized in terms of combos to the point where it started to invalidate some of her other specials. And even her super, like, you could just do more damage, no meter, if you optimize your combos just enough so that you can get maximum height finisher with the air C special. So now it's just an Azuna drop. It does a flat amount of damage that of course scales with your combo. But if you do the install, you now unlock a different set of special moves. Now the uppercut It hits upwards twice now. I'm getting a bit of input delay to the stream. But yeah, it hits upwards twice, so you can get a bit higher and kind of build your combos around that. Oh, that is not a good time. Hold on.
Is that a phone call?
Yeah. Sorry about that.
Wow.
Did not know I was streaming. But yeah, the B version of her special move now causes the freeze motion as it did before, and it hits them at a slightly higher angle. Both of these specials now help you a bit in maintaining and increasing the height of your opponent. But I just removed the height damage, right? Now, the thing is, the Izuna drop from before, now that is, it's based on your height. Like, that now adds damage based on your height. Instead of hitting you 100 times on the way down, it will just take whatever height you slammed from and then add that to your base damage. Now, the thing is, you can always do your combos when you're not on stream. And as soon as you're on stream, you're dropping even the first hits. Another thing that happens is that it causes a ground bounce, so you can actually combo after that, further increasing its value in the install mode. You almost get double damage from this version of the special. Is this too strong? Is it too weird and weak? I don't know. That's still up for actual testing. We're going through that right now. There are certain aspects of her level 2 that have been fighting against the base system we've had going up until now. But, you know, there's still a couple more things to try. And that's just the current iteration. Yeah, Izuna drop combos, always fun. Yeah, it's giving you damage on height, but it's not giving you like 5 million hits. That was actually really annoying in terms of audio. There were a lot of things we could have done about the audio, but it was a little too self-indulgent, I guess. I've not been much of a fan of attacks that hit 5 trillion times for like one button press.
It just plays the hit sound on every single...
Yeah, well, that too, but like just in general feel, if you hit a button once and a bunch of hits come out, it kind of changes a bit of how the move feels, and it's not one I'm too much of a fan of. It has to be something special.
Yeah, it definitely has its place.
Yeah. Besides that, it's just a bunch of like really minor things that were changed about each character. Not really anything to go over. But that's the main difference for the most part. She has a new Izuna drop. She gets a couple new specials from her install in the current version. We're still exploring some other options for that. Paprika has most of her stuff done now. She, at most, will gain one more move. Palm has a recall, finally. More players will be able to use this, use Palm without needing, you know, 4 hands. That should be beneficial for everyone. Lots of visual changes. You know, let people know what's going on in the match.
You just used to play it with 2 people.
Yeah. two players per palm.
One character.
Man.
Like, all right, I got the sheep, you got the pups. Okay, go.
Yep. Yeah, that'd be silly fun.
Yeah,
you have too many hands, Cam. That's not normal. I had to make this playable by humans. Yeah, you can still go manual. It's all fine. It's just the recall's there if you really want to get that quick setup. Get things to your position. And that's about it on my end. Actually, I just remembered.
What you remember?
Our programmer, Pineapple.
Oh.
Yeah. He's always
Oh.
working in the lab.
The lab.
Yeah,
You mean
just
the basement?
the
We
lab
change
in
the
the
floor.
basement. It's located in the basement.
We bring him food about once every 3 weeks.
And then he doesn't eat it. I don't know how he does it. But yeah, he's been working on training mode and some aspects of training mode that we'll be messing with as we polish things up. I was supposed to create a target icon for him, but I'm sorry. I was busy with a bunch of other stuff. So let's take a look.
Let's find out.
Hopefully this works. I'll put it in test room. Now, one of the scenarios that he built is a bit of a mini game where you attack certain targets. You reach to the end.
Oh.
Have to reach the end in a certain amount of time.
You're messing up.
Yeah, I'm just showing there are many different ways to approach this. Now,
Okay.
you see. Shows your time at the end and the time you should beat. Yes, these are tiny cows. They're supposed to be targets,
Whatever
but
happened to not touching the cow? I mean,
oh yeah, we've just
100%
completely
is.
destroyed that
That's out
rule.
the window.
We broke through about eight of those walls.
But yeah, as you try and beat these times, you'll start to get used to your character's movement options and attacks. Now, that was a bit of a better time there. Now, don't I have an attack that moves me forward? Oh yeah, I can use my headbutt. So maybe if I use a bit more of those and, short hops, use my super jump, I can get an even better time. Stuff like that. And over time, you'll kind of optimize or
Oh,
mess up.
random rope.
Yep.
Love it.
I messed it all up. But
Oh, goodness.
you'll optimize and kind of improve your times over time. And too close.
Started.
Yeah.
Oh, goodness. Here we go.
But yeah. But yeah, the general idea is you'll get used to your character's attacks and what they can do, and what you can do at certain distances. So you see there, I use my stomp to take care of that last target. You're gonna have a bunch of things like this to teach you how to use each character without overloading you with a bunch of words and information. I find this style of training, where you give them context and only, dump information on them when they're failing, I find that works pretty well. Plus, it's basically a mini game. It gives them something fun to do, and they don't even realize how much they're really learning. Kind of like the tutorial they have in the latest Guilty Gears. I've always wanted to make a tutorial like that. It's been killing me for such a long time that nobody was doing stuff like this until like Guilty Gear finally started doing it. It was like, see that's what I was talking about. They teach you through consistency and context, and I love it. And that's kind of what we're aiming for. As I said earlier, we had a bit of a competition on getting the lowest time on this mode. It was pretty fun. I think the Hey, I cheated on the first version because I had magic meter. Yeah, I can't use magic meter on this mode. Alright, using no magic. Trying to remember, I think this was the winning strategy. I think the lowest we got was 330 something, or 320 something. But yeah.
Anything else from the Kenneth lab?
Yeah, I'm sorry, I was just reading a bit of chat. Sandbag confirms next character. Yeah. How to space at max speed. It teaches you how to move across the stage, how far your attacks move, all that stuff, without just straight up telling you. It shows you. You kind of teach yourself.
This does this, this does this.
Yeah. Oh, yoy.
It's
I'm
like
so
playing
bad. I just
with
want to do
figuring
one
it
good
out.
run.
You retain that information and that muscle memory way better when you
Yeah.
use it as a solution to a problem rather than the solution being given to you immediately
Yeah,
as just
exactly.
information.
Yeah, that's Arizona's, I guess, target practice with tiny cows. We have another version of this, which is for Velvet. I broke this entirely. I feel kind of bad. Was it Velvet targets or targets Velvet? Let's see. Let's find out.
A one.
A to who?
I was just about to unmute myself.
Yep.
Thank you.
Took care of that for you. But yeah, you see a bunch of floating cows, and it's like, oh yeah, I am Velvet. I'm supposed to. Oh wait, hold on. Let me stop cheating real quick. I'm not supposed to have all this meter and all this magic. Give me a moment. Turn that off. Nothing. It's normal, normal. All right. Yes,
Oh,
even
go.
more cows. Oh, yeah,
They're
they're
moving.
differently colored cows now, and if you destroy them, you gain a magic meter. So, of course, you're Velvet, so you're supposed to be shooting these things with your icicles.
Clever.
And see, these things are pretty high up there. You can hit them with your jump B, take care of two of them, or you can shoot an upwards icicle. Now, of course, you'll think, oh, I'll fire a nice forward. No, these are actually too high for that. So you use your other icicles or your stand C. That's how it's supposed to be done. But,
What did you
I ignored all of that.
Did you just
Definitely
spam
not that.
up medium or something?
I didn't do this though. I'm trying to remember what was it. I think it was a. I basically exploit the fact that she's a slippery character and a bunch
Oh.
of jump dashes. I'm trying to remember. I had a whole routine going where I used a bunch of slide jumps. It's like when you dash with this character and you crouch, you'll slide a bit.
I love
And
that feature.
of course your dash jumps, just universally across all characters, your dash jumps are a bit faster than your normal jumps.
It feels good.
Since this is close enough for a launch, I just do this, I hit this, and usually that one's in the way. Oh, that's what I did. Okay, I used launch on both of those. Just give me a moment. And then I used that. Okay. Yeah, that was a bit closer to what it was, and I just ignored all of the stuff it was trying to teach me about projectiles. But at the same time, I could try and spin it and say I learned how to move a bit faster as Velvet, even though that's not really something I want to do.
That I wasn't supposed to learn,
I learned wrong.
but I did.
That's a joke.
That's a joke.
But yeah, that of course shows that there's a bit more that we're gonna have to do to ensure your well, You don't have to do it, but it's just there's just going to be a bit more of a variation to the way we lay out targets and various training situations. Like, we could have certain obstacles in a way that can only be broken with certain attacks and all that stuff. Lots to do, but you kind of see the general idea of just kind of a target practice, teaching you a bit about your character's tools.
Rad.
It's always fun getting these little test mini game scenarios from Kenneth when he occasionally pokes up from the basement.
It honestly increases my hype.
Yeah, like we want to make sure there's quite a bit more than just the base fighting in the game. Yes, the fighting is super important, of course, but it's not the only thing. Like, it's still a game. It's an entire package.
And you gotta teach people how to play the game.
Yeah, or just give them simple goals to just compete against themselves with. Like, simple time trial, things like this. Or consistency practice. Like, it's just little things to kind of nudge you gradually up towards being proficient with your character and your controls.
Or an overly involved single player.
And or.
End up with way too much feature creep. Oh, man.
Yeah, we're being careful of that. Like, we're making sure all the stuff's manageable. Like, a bunch of the stuff shares the same kind of tools and time investment as the rest of the game. So, should be good on that end. There was a bit of the story mode that we want to show, but we're still working on the art assets for that. It'll be fun. Like, we're having a little too much fun with the dialogue, to be honest, but...
The dialogue is amazing. Just letting everyone know.
Dialogue's the best part.
It's pretty silly. Pretty silly game. Yeah, that is all on my end. Like, couple character changes. Pretty much, 90%+ of the attacks are now in game. Some more visual stuff, and mini games. We're definitely headed towards that polished stage sometime soon. Lots of mechanics are in place. Any puns in the script? I promised at least 2 puns.
Yeah, I should hope so.
I even gave one pun by... Yeah, before it was exactly 2, but I don't know how we'd be able to keep that up. I gave one by accident with the whole, veal trouble. Not intended. Entire dialogue is just a transcript of chat. Oh, God. No, so, I almost got it. Oh,
so close.
Oh, yeah. I guess I'll answer a couple more questions, and I should be done. Unless Luke wanted to show more of the stuff. Not as Mike's working.
Definitely going to have to not do the Hangouts thing.
You're confident to go. We can swap over.
Not exactly confident, but... There's no way it can be worse. Right? Wait.
Don't do that.
The jinx.
You've already ruined it. Alright, we'll give it a shot after this run.
After this run.
I'm telling you, this is addictive. Oh my god, damn it! I almost got it. Almost!
You ruined it.
Oh well. 3:30. It was 3:31 on this one. Oh, we had such good times on this. One very last run. Absolute last run.
Okay.
Oy, oy. I should have slid that one. I double dashed. Oh well, 347. That's all right. Pretty good. Cool. All right, we'll swap over in just a moment. Okay. Just hold on.
Let's do it.
Oy, oy. Yeah, I'm a cheater.